Hello everybody, this is the Veek Strand. You know, when I was gonna do this review, I was thinking, we all love what if questions. What if 1987 Ridley Scott would have done another movie instead of Someone to Watch Over Me? You know, something unique, something interesting. Something we don't even know what it would have been. And some, you know, run-of-the-mill director, you know, some guy, like this guy, would have directed Someone to Watch Over Me. Today we probably wouldn't have remembered this movie at all. It probably would have been completely forgotten in time, and not just almost forgotten in time. But maybe 1987 would have read, you know, one of the best movies of Ridley Scott's career or something like that. We will always have these kind of questions. However, I cannot do anything about that right now. I can only review his 1987 movie, Someone to Watch Over Me. So we have New York City and Tom Berenger as a classical rough but honest New York cop, and you know, with family and loving wife, all that good stuff. When he's about to have a tender moment with his wife, the phone rings because Hollywood fucking hates couple who are going to have something nice together and wants to ruin it. So he has to pick it up because there has been a murder. They have an eyewitness, a Mimi Roger eyewitness. He gets the task to babysitter, to be her chaperone basically, until they can get this guy so she can identify him, you know, and witness in front of court or, you know, stuff like that. But as we all know, Hollywood fucking hates due process and, you know, trials and stuff like that. It's nothing that, you know, is new for, you know, today's product that we get from Tinseltown. It has been so for freaking ever. The problem is that while our knife enthusiast is looking for enthusiasing his knife with Mimi Rogers, Tom Berenger also develops feelings for her, and this becomes a bit of a romance thing between them, which kind of doesn't really work that well, because it would have been one thing if he would have been single or a widower or something like that, but now he has a wife, and are we rooting for him to, you know, leave his wife for, you know, committing adultery or something like that? I don't know. This is one of these cases where it needlessly complicates things for a movie that isn't that complicated to begin with. I granted it, but let's look at what's good about this movie, because it is made by a super pro. I mean, Ridley Scott has made tons and tons and tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of great movies. He's one of my favorite directors. When I saw this movie and saw that he was directed this one, I was I didn't even know that. To be fair, Ridley Scott probably makes this movie about, you know, 15, maybe 20 points better than it will end up being. It is not a bad movie. It's not a fantastic movie. It's a more than serviceable movie, and I don't have any problems with it in general. My problem is that it's pretty mundane. The story, you know, we have seen lots of times before, and Ridley Scott is a kind of a cold director. He doesn't, you know, make these warm and fuzzy and sappy movies, and they always have a cold edge to them. This is probably the warmest movie he has ever done, if that's a thing you can say. This is probably one of the more human movies he has ever done. We have really good actors. Berenger is good. Mimi Rogers is good. Most of the other characters in this one is also pretty good. But the thing is that the story isn't, you know, overly awesome or anything like that. It's a pretty neatly shot movie, but it isn't anything out of the ordinary. We have lots of cliches, and the story is pretty predictable. If you like, you know, your classical and 80s cop movies and have missed this one, it's pretty okay. You kind of know from the beginning where this is going to go, and you will get there, and it will be competently made. It is a pretty good thriller without anything new or original attached to it. Personally, I don't think that thriller and romantic movies really work in that sense. In the same way, you cannot make romantic horror movies, really. It's very difficult. If you're gonna pull that one off, you have to have a absolute super script, and they don't have that. Still, I give this movie 53 points. It is still made by one of my favorite directors of all time. It has good music. It is very competently made, but nothing really stands out from it. It's just a pretty good movie. Well, join me next time where I will be reviewing, well, so-and-so from, well, such-and-such. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much.